What's cooking?
Time for some belly dance brunch.
That's right. That's
Welcome
right,
Welcome back to What's Cooking. We're gonna do belly dance brunch today,
that's
right?
That's right. But we can't start without you being outfitted.
Am I going to be honorary member here?
That's right.
All right, good. Fair enough. All right, what do I do?
All right, I'm going to put this around you so you feel festive. All right.
And traditionally, men don't wear this, do they?
They wear something like it.
Okay.
Maybe not quite as festive, but they do. Okay, so now you're ready.
Okay, good. Put me on.
All right. Well, the thing is that brunch is a kind of meal that a lot of people want to have, but they just think it's just too labor intensive.
Right.
Why I just feel too lazy.
When I think about brunch, I think about pancakes and really heavy food, and then I don't want to move for 6 hours afterwards. But it looks
like you're asleep on the couch after that. But the great thing is that a lot of the foods that are indigenous to the same places that belly dance comes from are really good for you because they combine proteins like what we have here when we have hummus.
Okay.
And it'll combine oils like we have with olive oil, or I like to add omega-3 oils to when I'm making the hummus, et cetera. It also combines a lot of vitamin C within the salsa that we have. Right. So we can cheat. Yeah.
Okay.
So we don't have to make all this stuff from scratch. We can have a really nice hummus. This kava metza is really, really delicious.
It's kind of nice as the weather gets warmer, not to be eating.
Exactly.
Not too heavy. Right.
Exactly. So this with olives, really nice spiced olives, really nice tabbouleh. Really nice. We have some great hummus.
And all of this is good
for you. Yeah, and see, the thing that happens is that the combination of these things go so well together that you do not feel heavy, and the spices cause you not to eat so much.
And I got to be honest with you, I'm waiting patiently for the end of the show so I can taste it.
I know, you guys always tear the whole
table. I know,
that's
all I'm about right here right now. All right, so tell me about lemonade. You're going to make some lemonade?
That's right. Let's make some pomegranate lemonade.
All right, now tell me what's special about pomegranate lemonade.
Well, pomegranate is great because it's really rich in antioxidants and vitamin C, etc. And then, of course, you have that with the lemonade, too.
Right.
But if you're not going to go and juice pomegranates, have you seen them? They have all the little seeds.
I mean, I'm not going to do that.
Labor-intensive.
Right.
So we're making easy brunch here.
Okay.
These are some of my favorite things for that. Then what we're going to do is we're going to use a lemonade already, and Whole Foods has given us some of their organic lemonade.
Good stuff.
You have one right down the street at Tinley, the Tinley Whole Foods. So we're going to use some of their lemonade. That's very easy to do.
All right.
And then you can either use a juice like palm. I love the shape of the bottle. Very belly dance friendly.
Never had it before. I'm looking forward to trying it.
It's great stuff.
All right.
We can use that. Like the blueberry.
And what's the ratio here for me? Because I'm really not too quick with this. Kind of.
Oh, okay.
Well,
about 2 to 1 to this. And then some pomegranate syrup, something like this, Osmars.
Okay, and I can find that at a local supermarket, a Whole Foods
has it.
All right.
Right down the street here in Tinley, they have that. And then you put some of that. And you're ready to rock and roll. And then you can't do a lot of Mediterranean foods, North African foods, etc., without mint.
All right.
So we put a little mint. Smell that.
Mm.
Isn't that nice?
All right. So coming up, we're going to taste the lemonade.
That's
we're going to dance for you. And I'm going to eat just about everything that you have out here today.
Yes, but we must dance.
Oh, I promise you will. You see me?
Yes. All right.
Oh.